Well, it's Monday. You know what that means. It's time to get paid. Back to the coin mines we go. In Mount Teapot. So, whoa. Well, that's an interesting way to start the level. Now I know to avoid those little spiky ball things. So I've been slacking a little bit on the coin collecting. From what I understand, collecting a lot. Whoa. Cool, you can hit down to fall faster in the water. That's kind of neat. So from what I understand, oh crap. I couldn't swim up and I couldn't walk in the water fast enough to outrun the seahorse. So from what I understand, it's important to collect quite a few coins in this game. And I haven't been doing such a great job of that. At least so far. And, whoa. That's a lot of simoleons. So, I'm going to, wow. I'm going to try to do a better job of collecting money to turn in at the end of level, you know, treasure hoard thing. Aww. Bummer. Because to get the quote-unquote best ending in this game, at least from what people have told me, it requires a lot of coins. I'm going to have to step up my game a little bit. You know, it's time to get greedy, as Wario might be fond of saying. And you know, that will probably mean, whoa. Oh, here's a new hat. What does this do? Oh! Well, it looks kind of like the bunny ear hat from the previous Mario Land game. But it's way cooler than that. Wow, that is a really cool ability. It's a jetpack that only goes horizontally and eventually runs out of fuel, but still. It's like taking Wario's charge attack, the dash, to like its ultimate level. Nice. Wow, that's really cool. I'm gonna have to hang on to this hat. And it works underwater, unlike all the other hats. Whoa! Oh, I didn't realize the seahorses had that little sonic dash attack thing. Man, that is such bullcrap. I'm still trying to learn the rule system of this game. Like sometimes it seems like I can do that dash attack and I can run into enemies however I want. Man, I wasn't that close to that thing. Bummer. Sometimes it seems like, you know, if I hit something that looks like a spike, then I take damage. Sometimes it's not actually a spike, and ugh. And it's just very, very confusing for someone who's used to a traditional Mario game. I mean, even Mario Land 2 still stuck to, like, the basic rules of Mario for, like, the way you take damage and the way you can attack enemies. And in this game, it's just completely backward from anything you've ever known, so requires, you know, just a little getting used to. I think I'm getting the hang of it more so than in the previous video, though. I wonder if these coins disappear if they stay on screen too long. That's the sort of thing you would expect, but I mean, they were, like, flashing, but I don't know if that was just sprite flicker or not. Man, same mistake. Same dang mistake I made in my last life. In my previous incarnation. So yes, I need to focus more on collecting as many coins as I can, but also not focus too much on that and end up dying in unpleasant ways. wanted to blow that mine up so I could uncover the rest of those blocks, since there's coins hidden in some of them. Of course, I don't know how important getting the best ending actually is, since... Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. I should have been able to hit that bird. I don't know why I wasn't able to. But yes, that treasure screen that you see at the end of every level, where it takes all the coins you've accumulated and puts them into, like, you know, a stash. I don't think that has any actual, like, gameplay implications. I don't think there are actual, like, bonuses or rewards that you get for unlocking any of those. I'm pretty sure it's just all flavor text. And there might be a story to this game that was, like, in the manual that I'm not aware of. And you have to get really close to this thing to trigger it sometimes. It's weird. Man, so bummed about how I lost my jetpack. I know I did the charge attack into those birds before. Was it because I hit the beak? I mean, the beak is, like, pointy like a spike. Is that enough to knock me out? I don't know. It's hard to tell. Come back here, you. Oh, I guess the coins do disappear if they're just sitting around on the ground for a long enough time. Well, you can jump really high when you jump out of the water. Sigh. And no checkpoint yet. Man, this game's rough. This game is definitely harder than the previous games in the series. I mean, again, that might just be because I'm not used to it. I'm not used to the way it controls and the rules of the game and everything. Maybe the reason I got hit by that bird was because it was doing its charge attack as well. So yeah, what I might do is do, like, a bonus stream where I go back to some of the previous levels and I do a little bit of coin collecting and I look for some of the secrets that I missed, because there are definitely secrets that I'm missing. At least there were in the previous level. Someone said that once you beat the game, All of the levels with secrets are revealed on the map, like they flash or something. So maybe once I beat the game, I'll do the bonus stream, and I'll go back and I'll basically just replay the whole game, just like in a marathon kind of situation. And I'll go back and collect some coins and see if I can find some of those secrets. And I'll make it a bonus stream, so those of you who aren't interested in watching me, you know, do the same things again, won't have to. Really wish I had some way of dealing with these seahorses. I mean, even when I have the jetpack, I have to be super careful. I don't even know. Can I hit them from this side? Doesn't look like it. No, when I get that close to them, then they just do their spin attack. Oh, hey! Well, here's a secret. That's definitely something I missed in previous runs. Oh, there's a checkpoint. Nice. Kinda sucks that it cost me 10 coins to activate it. And of course... Oh, I didn't want that! Wow. Going in that secret door was a huge mistake. I didn't know what that power-up was. I thought it was just... I thought the hat that gives you the horns, like, has horns on it. I thought... I don't know what I thought that was. Well, it's a real shame that you can downgrade your power-ups. I always hate it when video games do that. Like, in Mario, if you have a fire flower, in some Mario games, you can't even get a mushroom. Like, that option just never comes up if you have a fire flower. And in some Mario games, if you do get a mushroom, it doesn't actually downgrade your power-up. It just gives you points or something. And the bowl hat is definitely a downgrade from the jetpack. It's like when you're playing Ghosts and Goblins or something, and you have... Like, I don't know what an example of a good weapon in that game would be. I guess a spear. Or the lance. Oh, hey. And then you pick up, like, the dagger or something useless like that. You know, you shouldn't have to avoid power-ups in a video game. It shouldn't punish you for picking up the wrong power-up by mistake. Just my two cents. I just discovered that I can hold the jump button to swim instead of pumping it like I have been doing. Oh, can I get in there? That's a lot of coins. Man, the seahorse is going to hassle me, isn't it? No, I bet I probably need the jetpack. Well, no. I bet if I get close enough to this mine, it'll blow up these blocks. Maybe I have to actually touch it. Maybe it doesn't hurt me. It doesn't look like it actually hurts me unless it explodes. So that's good. So I can touch it and activate it, and I'm in good shape. Hopefully that heart stays there, so I can actually collect that. It looks like by going off the screen, I made it so the mine doesn't blow up. Okay, so that's good to know. I don't have to worry about running into those mines unless they're actually exploding. Uh oh, telling me to get a move on. Oh wow, that wasn't even the end. Oh, here's the end, I think. Cost me 10 coins just to end the level. Bogus. Oh, that's 76 coins. That's not too bad. Alright, do I want to play either of these games? I mean, I don't have to. CPC Gamer left a comment and said that I can just leave if I want. But man, doubling my coins would sound pretty good. But, I mean, it's just like a 50-50 shot. It's not like there's anything I can do, you know, to influence the odds or anything. I think I'm just going to leave. I want to add 76 coins to my stockpile. I'm more than double what I already had. That's pretty good. Do I unlock a treasure for that? No. Dang it. It's going to be a while before I get any treasures, I think. Man, I hope I get another one of those jetpacks. That thing was awesome. Oh, it's like the current was sweeping me away. That's interesting. Best power-up in any of the Mario Land games so far, that jetpack. Oh man, can I get in there? I can't tell if those stalactites are going to hurt me or not. Hopefully not. Oh, I see. I just kind of automatically ducked under them. That's cool. So not something I have to worry about. I still don't know why I couldn't dash into that bird. Alright, can't dash underwater, so there's no way to actually fight the current. I'm just gonna have to come around. Go the long way. Wow, that screen shake is kind of obnoxious. Oh, okay, so I can fight the current. I just have to, like... Nice. Oh, this isn't the jetpack, but it's still pretty cool. So, you can't fight the current, you just have to be swimming. You can't walk and fight the current. Okay. Hmm. Always a good time when you can use fire underwater. That's a jetpack, right? Yes! Nice. So I wonder how many power-ups there actually are. Because, I mean, the jetpack didn't show up at all in the first zone. Or the first world or whatever. Crap! The way those things bounce really makes me nervous. So I wonder if there are other power-ups that will only show up in later worlds. Do I want to spend 10 coins to activate that checkpoint? Nice, another jetpack. I probably should. Even though, man, if I want to save up coins, activating those checkpoints definitely is not the way to do it. Because A, you have to spend coins just to activate it, and B, if I do die and respawn there, then I miss out on like the 50 coins I would have collected up to that point. So, you know, it's a real trade-off. I mean, for the purposes of this LP, I think it's best for me. It's best for me to just kind of try to make it my way through the levels. Not as quickly as possible, but you know, as efficiently as possible. Like, for the purposes of an LP, I do not want to collect that. I will collect that though. You know, I don't want to do the same things over and over again, and you know, bore you guys more than I have to. So I'll save the coin collecting for the bonus stream. I don't know if I can charge into this thing or not. I mean, maybe I only get hurt if I touch the spike? Or maybe I can charge it from the side, I don't know. Okay, so I just bounce off. See, that's so weird. Why... The rules for what you can and cannot charge into in this game still confuse me. Oh no! Oh, okay. So I'm assuming that if I touch that thing in its spike, then I'll be in trouble. Maybe. Okay. So I can hit it with my head and kill it that way. That's so weird. I don't understand. You can sort of look at the way those particles are moving and figure out what the direction of the current is. But you know, on a Game Boy screen with as few colors as you have to work with, it's not always crystal clear which direction they're moving. Alright, so I'm going to hit that thing from the bottom and grab that box. I don't know why that works, but it works. I'll get a 1-up if I grab that thing. Oh! Oh, cool. Well, I guess they put that guy there for a very good reason. Out of time? Almost. Oh, it wants me to go up. Oh, I see. I have to wait for this thing to throw a knife here, and then I can jump up there, I bet. Yeah! I figure something out. I am cool. Yes! Alright, eventually I'm going to have to throw caution to the wind and just say, you know, it's worth the gamble. But today's not that day. Again, maybe during the live stream. I will, still no treasure? I guess not. Wow. I unlocked an entirely new area by doing that? I guess it's kind of like in Mario Land 2, the way you have to unlock Space Zone by taking an alternate route out of a level. Well, that's cool. I'm glad I... Oh, you know what? That, the icon on the map has a little, like, circle, or it has a little dot in the level icon. So, I bet that indicates a secret. Which, you know, makes a lot of sense. I didn't really notice those before. Okay, well, I'll save Sherbert Land for the next video. And for now... No. For now, I will just concentrate on finishing up Teapot Mountain. Or Mount Teapot. Don't know why that didn't work. I guess it's because I hit that thing's claws. I don't know. I really wish there was some clear indication as to whether something in this game will hurt you or not. Because, I mean, as it is, there's just nothing. Oh, well. There's another jetpack here, so I'm not too broken up about it this time. But still... Still just a little bit frustrating. So does that thing stay activated once I activate it? I guess not. Well, I don't want to spend 10 more coins to activate it again. Especially since I'm pretty familiar with this level now. I should hopefully be okay for the rest of it. Ooh! 3 hearts. Doesn't really make a big deal out of it when you get an extra life in this game. I kind of didn't even notice that my counter rolled over. I mean, I noticed that it was about to, but it didn't like make a big fanfare or anything like that. All right, I should probably break all these blocks for coins, just to be thorough. Not sure if there's anything in them or not, but never hurts to check. I kind of like that there's a persistent coin counter in this game. That's kind of cool. Makes things seem a little bit more important somehow. All right, can I hit this thing from the bottom with my head? I can, but it just like flips it over, and to actually kill it, I have to do a charge into it. Very, very curious. Alright, currents. Be aware that I'm gonna fight you every step of the way. Might as well just give up now. Currents never listen to you. They just kind of do their own thing. Okay, so it gives you like just a little tinkling noise and it says one up, but oh no! No! Dang it. So I was wrong about the mohawk being the thing that allows you to damage enemies. It's just your head. The mohawk is just incidental. But still, it's only like certain enemies. I'm not gonna be able to get this thing, am I? Nope. Or maybe it's every enemy, I don't know. Some enemies you can hurt just by walking into them. Alright, real exit completed. Exited. Alright, dang it. One out of three times, I'm gonna have to try to be extra greedy. Hey, it worked! You know what I'm gonna do? Quit while I'm ahead. If you ever go to Vegas with a pocket full of money, and you're actually able to double it, don't keep gambling. Quit while you're ahead. I don't have first-hand experience with this philosophy, since I'm not much of a gambler in real life. But, you know, just general advice. Of course, the problem with that is, then you're in Vegas, and you don't have anything to do because you stopped gambling. I guess there's other stuff to do in Vegas. There's like shows to see and stuff. But yeah, that's the secret to gambling effectively. You know, have a set amount of money that you're going to spend. If you lose that amount of money, you're done gambling. If you increase that amount of money, great, you should probably stop. I did actually go gambling in real life once. We have like a racetrack nearby that has like the video slot machines and stuff. And I brought $20 and I was ahead. I managed to double it. I had $40, I kept going, and then by the end of the night I had $20 again, and I was like, okay, that's enough for me. I doubled my money and foolishly squandered it. So, you know, that's my one gambling story. My one dark moment of not being able to control myself. Because, you know, you feel pretty good when you double your money. You're like, hey, I'm on a roll. I'm doing pretty good. But, you know, it's all fleeting. Just trying to make sure that there's nothing else around here that I'm missing. There's no dot on the level icon, so I should be good. I probably wouldn't do, like, slot machines again. Since slot machines, they're not a whole lot of fun. I mean, it's kind of like, oh man, bogus. So, can I not jump on these guys because they have a helmet? Is that? Oh, okay. I mean, slot machines are kind of just like playing Farmville, which I don't think that's fun either. You just kind of sit there and do the same things over and over again, and then eventually, hopefully, a number goes up. Well, in Farmville, the number always goes up, but you can pay money to make it go up faster. With slot machines, sometimes the number goes up, and when that number does go up, you feel happy. But when the number doesn't go up, why can't I? It's giving me the nope. What? I should be able. Man, I do not get this game sometimes. And like, I want to kill this guy, I want to throw him into the wall and make him disappear. And the game was like, nuh-uh. For some reason, you can't do it this time. But yeah, if I want to play a game where I just sit and watch numbers go up, I'll probably play like a JRPG instead. You know, you don't have the... You don't have the financial element there. Like, I don't have to risk losing money. And what? Whoa, what is that? Oh, it's a key. I thought it was a key, but I wasn't sure. I thought it might, or is it like a flask? Is it like an Erlenmeyer flask or something? Pretty sure it's a key. But yeah, with a JRPG, at least one that's not like one of these free-to-play pieces of crap, your numbers go up, and you're like, hey, it's I'm level 12 now, awesome. And you know, it goes up at a steady pace. You don't have to pay money to make it go up at a reasonable rate. That number's not going to go down. So you know, it's just one serotonin hit after another. You're like, hey, this number went up. I'm happy. Well, I guess I better carry this thing with me. So, wait, this is the end of the level, isn't it? So I can stand on this thing when it's closed, but once it's open, I can no longer stand on it. But that's the end of the level, then where does the key go? Can I use the key, like, instead of paying the 10 coins? Is it... No? Well, I don't want to end the level until I figure out what to do with this thing. Man, the physics in this game are so weird sometimes. Why do I bounce off when I walk into this thing? I don't know. Is there like an invisible, like a wall? Not an invisible wall, but like a visible wall that's not actually there? Well, I'm running out of time, so I better figure this out soon. This might be one that I have to revisit in a bonus stream. I mean, I'm not sure what else I can be missing here. I can't use my jetpack while I'm carrying the key, so I can't go around, you know, I can't jet around looking for stuff. Okay, I am running dangerously low on time, so I'm just going to get out of here. Sorry guys, I'll have to revisit this at a later date. What? Yep, I can no longer stand on it and it doesn't bounce me off anymore. That's so bizarre. And I can't bring the key with me, so whatever it is, it's something I need to do in that level. Alright, should I try for some extra lives? I'd have to spend 20 coins on the cheapest option, and I'm not really guaranteed to get anything. I think I'm doing okay with my 7 lives, actually. Come on, treasure. Oh, come on. How much do I need just to unlock the A? Well, there's no dot in that level. So, the key must go to something. It must lead to like a cache of extra lives or a cache of coins or something like that. There's not going to be like a secret level in that one. All right, I should leave that bunny hat there just in case I get hit, so I have a backup. Pretty sure it'll stay there. It looks like everything stays put. Well, speaking of needing a backup, it seems like everything stays put except for the coins. Like the coin, like that one, the coins that come out of blocks, they disappear eventually. But everything else seems to stay in place, like that. If I lose my jetpack, I need to stop saying stuff like that. Alright, well, I can go back and get that that big power-up now, hopefully. Man, little Wario is so slow. Oh, I don't think I can't even get that now, can I? Wait, yeah, that's right. I can jump super high when I jump out of the water. Alright, so I can hit those things from their rear. That's nice. That's good to know. I guess it's just their claws. Just the clamps. But seahorses... Oh! Thank goodness. Another jetpack. Aw, I should have gone under there while I was tiny. Well, maybe I can, like, crawl under there. Does that work underwater? No, it doesn't. Oh, that's a bummer. Oh well. It's only 10 coins and a block. Can't do the butt stomp with this thing either. The butt stomp only seems to happen when you have the bull helmet. Which, it's kind of interesting that, like, the base power-up in this game has abilities that you don't have when you have the better power-ups. I don't know, it's like each power-up is situationally useful, like, in its own way. Aw, come on. What do you mean there's nothing... Ooh, there was something up there. I didn't have enough momentum to grab it. Nice. I'm gonna have to reevaluate that plan. Give it another try. So even when I leave the screen, the power-ups stay in place. That's really cool. Oh, you sucker! You sucking sucker. Oh, man. So yeah, cannot butt stomp with the dragon. Let's see, well, I can get the bowl and do the butt stomp and see what's in here. So, I mean, it's kind of like there is no... Like, with Mario, you have the mushroom, which is your base power-up, and then that upgrades to the fire flower, or the tanuki tail, or whatever. But in this game, it's kind of like each power-up is its own level of useful. Oh, no! Like, you can have the jetpack, which is awesome. But if you get somewhere where you need to do a butt stomp, you're out of luck. Oh man, I have so many coins, I don't want to lose them. I don't want to go back to the beginning of this level. Oh nice. I guess I missed that the first time through. I was just going to go up and see if I could get a little bit of momentum to jump over to this platform, but I guess not. Oh well, I just have to jump a little more carefully than I would normally have to. And the enemies in this game are just ruthless, and there's so many of them. Nice. Not as cute as the Mario 2 enemies, or Mario Land 2 enemies, I have to say. They're just kind of more annoying. What? I was trying to run across the top of that swamp. I don't know why it killed me instead of just hurting me. Why did I get a one-up? Oh, I guess I got hearts from something. Oh, this game is so confusing. Now I have to do this whole thing over again. Oh well, at least I can get this now. I just needed to not use my jetpack there. As tempting as it was. I can get this now too. Well, no, I guess I can't. Well, I could get hit deliberately, get that stuff, and then go up and get that hat, which is exactly what I will do. Okay, it's just a bunch of coins and a heart. Boy, if I'm having this much trouble with Mount Teapot, I hate to think what the later levels are going to be like. I mean, I'm already at 40 minutes, and I don't even know if this is the boss level. Maybe you get hearts for, like, killing enemies or something, and I just didn't notice. Yep, I was at 36 and now I'm at 37. Interesting. I didn't realize that was going on. I thought the only source of hearts was the pickups. Okay, don't want that. I keep forgetting to remember that I don't have to pump the button underwater. Alright, same plan. Get shrunk. Get the stuff. Get the rabbit hat. Be more careful around that seahorse. And why are they swimming backwards? I guess it's so their primary defense mechanism is on display. Their primary means of defending themselves is out there for potential predators to see. Potential predators like me. Alright, so now I can figure out what I missed. Over yonder. Oh, still not a good enough jump. No! You've gotta be kidding me. I mean, not that the bull hat is bad, but I really wanted to see what was up there. It's probably just like hearts or an extra life or something like that. I don't think I've gotten any like actual extra life pickups. The only extra lives I've gotten have been from collecting 100 hearts. Pretty sure. Well, I guess now I'll get the dragon hat. I mean, it's cool. It's not as cool as a jetpack, but that power-up also makes you run really fast. Hey, you. I swear I saw one of those pickups that had, like, little horns on it. And I thought that was the bull hat, but I guess I was mistaken. So I had to give up my dragon hat to get a bunch of coins, but it'll be worth it in the end, hopefully. I mean, being able to stun the enemies like that is pretty nice as well. So that gave me a 1-up. I guess because I already had the bull hat, but now I kind of wish I left that in place. Oh, Duke. You are in so much trouble. There's a billion enemies here. And your tiny defenseless Wario. I have to say, not too impressed with the music in this game so far. I mean, I guess it's fine for what it is, but I like the percussion in Mario Land 2 a lot. Doesn't seem to be as much percussion in this game. Alright, I've got to be getting pretty close. Alright, you asshole. You are not going to do whatever you did to me last time. I don't know why just touching that. Oh man, the exit was right here too. Oh my god, that was almost a disaster. Alright, press my luck? Sure, why not? Alright, so last time I did the right bucket, and it turns out that was correct. So this time, the game is expecting me to do the left bucket, because I wouldn't expect it to be the right bucket twice in a row. So I'm going to use reverse psychology on the game, and go with the right bucket. Since it's... See? It anticipated my reverse psychology. Alright. So it's definitely... I should just leave. The game bested me. Don't use reverse psychology on video games. It doesn't work. Because video games don't think. That's what I've learned from my experiments in video game reverse psychology. Look for my paper in the Journal of Psychology this July. Why does this only work sometimes? I don't understand. I went to get rid of... Oh, well, I guess that works. Glitch the game and get it trapped in the wall. Alright, so maybe I was premature in my assessment of the physics of this game being better than the Mario Land 2. Because this game is doing some really baffling things. I mean, I still like the game, don't get me wrong. It's just... it's inconsistent. Like, I should be able to throw enemies up against a wall, and they should die. That's how it's worked with most of the enemies in this game. But with those guys, it wasn't working. Or maybe I just wasn't standing in the right place. See, here's another good thing about the bull hat. You can actually crawl. You can't do that with some of the other hats. Go away! I want to crawl under there. Get out of my way, you stupid fuzzy thing. You don't make me get dizzy. I'm not interested in you, fuzzy. I don't know why I call it fuzzy. I don't actually know what this thing is. So to get rid of those things, just keep throwing them against something until they glitch and get trapped in the wall and die. Or I could just butt stomp them. I guess that works too. Oh man, these guys again? No, I thought I was done with you. Alright, so that time it didn't give me a 1-up. Maybe it gave me a bunch of hearts, and I just didn't notice. I don't know. This game is weird. This game is super, super weird. And I like it. It might just be... it might be out... it's out-weirding me. Okay, so you can't crawl with this hat. Whoa, what is that? Oh. I guess this is where I would need a key. So is there a key? Oh, it's right here. Nice. I don't like the look of the look of that door though. I mean, is this just going to be the boss door? Or what? I don't know. But I am excited to find out. Oh, hey. Interesting. So, I guess the treasures in this game work completely differently than I thought they did. I thought the treasures were just awarded to you for collecting a certain amount of loot. But it looks like you actually find them in the environment, which I did not know. I had no idea. I was going to ram my head into that thing since it's... no, I don't want that. What is this? Oh god. Oh, it's like that block from Mario 3. You jump on it to change the direction it moves. Very cool. Also very scary with those spikes above my head. So I guess I have to go back and start looking for treasures now as well. Damn. So I'm assuming that's what that key that I didn't know what to do with and that I didn't know what to do with it a couple levels ago. I assume that's for some other... Oh, hey! That's for some other treasure. Look at how fast I am with this thing. This is all the rabbit hat. This is the invincibility making me that fast. I thought that was just water. Oh, I'm an idiot. I thought, well, it wants me to go through that door, so obviously I should try the other direction and see what's there. Down in that water, but it was not water. I might have to start splitting these videos up. Do half of a zone per level instead of a whole zone, because this is just taking way longer than I expected it would. Which, I mean, that's not a bad thing. I mean, having a long game is fine. Oh, I guess the invincibility is giving me a little bit of a speed boost. Okay, don't go in the lava. Don't go in that lava either. Oh great, that bridge disappears. Nice. Oh. Well, at least I don't have to pay to exit the level this time. I don't know why that was already open, but I'll take it. Alright, coins. I don't like you and you don't like me, but listen here. That's what I thought. Thank you. That's all I wanted. I mean, really, 48 coins, is that so much of a tragedy to give me that? I guess I can stop hoping for treasure to unlock, because I don't think that's how it works. That looks like something I can ride. Oh, I guess not. I don't know why it had a basket on its head. Dang it. No! I don't know why it bounced me backwards. That doesn't seem to usually happen when I run into an enemy, but maybe it does. I don't know. Get down there? Do I want to risk it? I mean, I can probably do a dash jump and get to this other platform. Or not, you know. I bet I could have made it if I was closer to the edge. Man, there's a lot going on in this game. Alright, do I want to try this again? It's probably just hearts. And dying to get hearts. It's just the ultimate irony. It's like dying to get an extra life. Oh great, now I can't dash anymore. Can I still make this jump? Looks like I can. Yeah, okay. I'm in good shape. Now you see this is what I call an attack. You know, I know exactly how it's going to affect the enemies. I don't have to worry, is this going to... Okay, so that's the spike one, right? So why do some of them... With some of them, the power-up has little horn, or the horn helmet. But sometimes the power-up has the horn, sometimes it doesn't. Very, very inconsistent. Maybe I should read the manual. Maybe if I RTFM, it'll explain some of the mechanics in this game. It's probably a good idea for any game I decide to LP. I mean, I do want to go into the game blind. But, you know, reading the manual shouldn't count as looking up information about the game, since theoretically that's information that everyone who plays the game would have. Everyone who bought the game in its original, you know, packaging. So yeah, I should look up the manual on replacement docks and see if I can at least get a sense for how some of the rules in this game work. Oh no! Threw its scimitar at me. No, that's just the... Yeah, that's not something I want to pick up either. Well, I guess I'll pick it up now. Boy, this game never fails to find a way to say I told you so. What is this? Oh yeah, that's right. Oh. I guess that's the end of the level. Okay, so I have successfully put a lid on the teapot. Well, I only have 30 coins. I might as well. I might as well try something. Why not? See if I can, redeem myself in this game. Crap, it's probably already too late. That should have been close enough. If the thing walks into the explosion, that should count. Nice! See that? That time I like threw it directly at him, instead of, I don't know. What the? Oh. I guess I mistimed that one, huh? BS. That should have been a hit. Well, I guess 1 out of 5 ain't bad. Yes it is, what am I saying? Oh, I get 1 heart for that, great. At first I was like, oh, 1 extra life, that's not terrible, but that's not what it was at all. Oh, well, it's boss time, I guess. Interesting, so I had to do the whole level to get the lid to close, because the boss is in the lid. Oh, right, I can jump on those things. I don't like the looks of that thing one bit. At least the jumping feels better in this game. That's the one thing I can say for it over Super Mario Land 2. The jumping feels very natural. That was my that was my panic sound. I go, pretty intense. Oh, what? Whoa, get away from me. No. WTF. And we're at the hour mark. I'm definitely going to have to start splitting these videos up. Sorry, guys. I know I know an hour-long video is a little much. Alright, so how do I avoid having this thing latch onto me? I don't know. Maybe there's some way to shake it off once it attaches to you. I mean, flailing around didn't really seem to help that much. Which is weird, because that usually works. In any situation. When all else fails, flail around a little bit. And all this stuff I'm missing because I'm tiny. It's a real drag. There we go. See, at least the dragon power-up always looks the same. And the rabbit ears power-up. That's always the same icon. Good old trusty dragon and rabbit. Oh, why are these already triggered? You know, this area looks very familiar. Why? Have I been here? Have I been here before? I mean, this is a new level, right? But I already did. I already came down here. Oh no, this is. Oh yes, this is definitely different. It's weird. It looks very similar to one of the levels I already did. Oh, come on. There's no speeding up with this hat. Okay, I guess I can't go that way. At least that thing seems to have stopped following me. Oh, hey! Did I hit it? I guess so. Oh no! Now what do? I have no idea. Well, hopefully, I already hit it twice. I only have to hit it one more time. Do I have to hit it from the bottom again? That's sure what it looks like. Or is that not a hit? Is that just stunning him? And I have to, okay. I have to do something else. I hit him in exactly the same way I hit him those other two times. I jumped into his butt with my head. I headbutted his butt with my head. And I died that time. I mean, I don't think the manual is going to explain things like that. Like why I can hit him in the butt sometimes, but not other times. I don't know. Maybe that power-up just gives you a better version of what you already have. So if I was small, then that power-up would have just been... It would have just made me big. But since I was already big, it gave me the bullhorns. And then if you have the power-up that has the horns on the icon, that gives you the bullhorns whether you're tiny or not. I mean, it's a little weird that it would, like, make that distinction. Like, that's a little bit, it's a little bit confusing. I'm not gonna Not gonna lie. This is a confusing game. I mean, I like how different it is from Mario, but I don't like how inconsistent it can be. Like that bull. I'm still pretty mad about that. I jumped in. Okay, so yeah, I'm pretty sure my theory about that, when it's just the bottle, it either gives you horns or it just makes you big, depending on your current state. So I wonder what happens. I guess when you have horns and you get the bottle, that's when it gives you the 1-up. Because that one time, I got the bottle and it gave me a 1-up when I had the bullhorns. Oh, hey. Oh, can I actually get up there, though? I don't think so. And those seahorses are just unfair. Maybe, I was gonna say, maybe if I did an air dash and like bounce off this wall and bounce backwards, I might get enough upward momentum, but I don't think so. No! I was finally gonna be able to open this box. And this box. Slightly frustrating. I mean, from what I understand, the later games in the Wario series are better than this one. So maybe by the time the Game Boy Advance version comes around, which is, what, Wario Land 4, I think? Maybe by that point, they get some of the mechanics nailed down. Oh no. I can't even go that way now. Now that I'm tiny. But I mean, I have to say, just based on how weird the mechanics are, I don't think I like this as much as I like Mario Land 2. I mean, yes, I do appreciate doing something different, but this might be, it's not too different, it's just, it's different in not the best way. Huh, now where? Oh, I guess now I have to go back and do the thwomp thing, because there's no additional way to go when you go in this direction. At least now I can get these. Oh man, this is gonna be a lot harder without my dragon hat. Wait, can I actually go this way now? Oh wait, no, I can't butt stomp, right? That's what I needed to get. Oh wait, no. I actually don't know how to get down there. Maybe if I was able to butt stomp, I would be able to pass through these platforms, but won't be able to test that theory. That looks like it might be a direction you can go as well, but I'm not going to risk it. Alright, so jump over the bull. If he throws you, just don't panic. Just hold the other direction. Alright. Hit him from the bottom. Don't land on his horns, even when he's stunned like that. Okay, so what do I do when he's stunned? That's the real question I want to answer. Or is that actually damaging him and I just have to do that enough times? Alright. Just a video game. Not going to get frustrated. Would have been really, really nice if there was a checkpoint on this level somewhere. Maybe there is, and I just missed it. I don't know. Maybe there was a door I didn't find or something. I mean, I'm definitely not going to cut this video now. Now that I'm actually at the boss. From this point on, though, I'm going to tackle these zones in smaller chunks. Like, I'm going to do this is the rabbit hat, and I actually don't know how to get it. I have no idea, because if I charge into it, I'm going to fall, and once I fall, I'm not going to be able to get back up here. That's a real bummer. Maybe I can bounce off this thing and get more height that way. Well, definitely can't now. I wonder why that thing didn't stick to me that time. The first time I activated the bomb part of that enemy, it stuck to me. Alright, screw coins, screw secrets, I just want to get through this damn level. Yeah, from here on out, it's going to be, you know, Mount Teapot Part A, Mount Teapot Part B, that kind of stuff. So I don't have to tackle each of these zones in one video segment, since these levels seem to be a lot longer than the Mario Land 2 levels. Alright, still don't know how to get over there, since I can't do the butt stomp. Alright, am I actually hurting him this time? I don't know. Oh! I had to throw him off. Okay. Well, that answers that question. Look at all that kabliki. Nice. Yeah, it's just not worth it in either case, really. I just want to hang on to my 163 coins. Throw them in the stash. Alright, so now I have a couple options. I can either go to Stove Canyon, or I can go up to... What was that called? Oh wait, down here, that's right. I can go to Stove Canyon or up to Sherbert Land, that's right. Think I'm going to go to Sherbert Land, I guess, since that's the secret one, and I should probably do that one, you know, get the secret out of the way before I do the actual main path. So yeah, this has been Let's Play Wario Land. Sorry this video is so long and frustrating. Next video will be longer. I'll probably, you know, start tackling these in a couple chunks instead of trying to do an entire zone in one video. So yeah, see you tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everyone. Goodbye.